Hola, ¿qué tal estáis? Hoy vamos a ver los verbos irregulares del presente de subjuntivo. I know it is difficult to remember all these different irregular verbs of all the different tenses. But today I'm going to show you some tips to remember these particular ones. So all you have to do is to remember very well the irregular verbs of the ordinary present tense. And then you just change the endings for the presente de subjuntivo. For example, the verb pensar, to think. In the ordinary present tense, when you want to say I think, you'll say pienso. So then, for the presente de subjuntivo, you'll say piense. You keep that irregularity. And you'll keep the irregularity for all the different persons except with nosotros and vosotros, like you do in the ordinary present tense. So you'll say piense, pienses, piense, pensemos, penséis, and piensen. It's exactly the same with the verbs that they change the O for UE. So for example, with the verb to return, el verbo volver, you'll say vuelva, vuelvas, vuelva, volvamos, volváis, and vuelvan. And you also use the same tip for the verbs that they change an E to an I. So the verb pedir, which means to ask for or to order, you'll say pida, pidas, pida. But for nosotros and vosotros, in this case, you have to keep the irregularity. So then you'll say pidamos, pidáis, and pidan. You'll keep the irregularity for all the verbs in presente de subjuntivo, then they change the E to an I. Let's see now the verbs that in present tense, the first person takes a go, or an zco, or a yo. Like, for example, the verb tener, to have. When you want to say I have, in the ordinary present tense, you say tengo. So, in presente de subjuntivo, you'll say tenga. You change the go to a ga. And you'll have to keep that ga for all the different persons. So then you'll say tenga, tengas, tenga, tengamos, tengáis, and tengan. You'll do the same with the verbs that in ordinary present tense, the yo takes a uzco. Like, for example, the verb conocer. When you want to say I know, you say conozco. So then this uzco will change to uzca. And you keep that for all the different persons. So then you'll say conozco, conozcas, conozca, conozcamos, conozcáis, conozcan. You do also the same with the verbs that in the first person in the ordinary present tense takes a yo, like the verb to build, which is construir. When you want to say I build, you say construyo. So then in presente de subjuntivo will be construya, and the rest will be construyas, construya, construyamos, construyáis, construyan. And then we've got other verbs that you just have to remember because they change completely, like the verb to be, for example. When you want to say I am, you say sea, which is completely different than soy. But then, if you remember this first one, it's easy to remember the rest. Will be seas, sea, seamos, seáis, sean. I hope this lesson has been useful for you. I know it is a tricky topic, but it is really important. Que tengáis una buena semana y hasta pronto. Adiós.